to coast and floorboards to shingles, this is the Money Pit Home Improvement Radio Show. I'm Tom Kraeutler.
And I'm Leslie Segrete.
We are here to help you with your home improvement project, so help yourself first. Pick up the phone and call us at 1-888-MONEYPIT, 888-666-3974. Well, a new year brings new trends in home improvement. We've got tips to help keep your house up to date coming up.
And are you looking for a little extra space? Well, your basement may hold the key, but finishing a basement is a lot more than clearing out the cobwebs and storing away the boxes. Learn what you need to consider before you make over that space just ahead.
And it's the age-old dilemma: when your appliances break down, do you fix them or replace them altogether? Our cheat sheet will help you save money by helping you make the right choice.
Jean in Iowa has a question about her heating and cooling system. Tell us what's going on at your money pit.
I have a 5-year-old high-efficiency furnace with the PVC pipe that comes out for the intake and the exhaust. And at the first joint, it's about a 45-degree angle. And we noticed that that joint wasn't totally sealed. But our question is, we noticed that there was condensation dripping out of that joint. So if we seal it, will that condensation go into our furnace and cause damage? We're not sure what we should do with it.
How old is this furnace?
5 years.
What's the efficiency of the furnace?
In the 90s.
I ask you this because some furnaces are designed to trap the condensation and pump it out. And so if you have a condensing furnace, then that might not be as much of an issue. Because what happens with those high-efficiency systems is they put the exhaust gases out at such a low temperature that they quickly turn from gas back to water, and then the moisture drains back through the vent pipe, gets caught by a condensate system, and then pumped out. So have you had it serviced this winter yet?
Not this winter.
Yeah, you really need to do it every year because, you know, the fact that the gas burns, it burns dirty, and then you get combustion deposits on the burners, and then they can become inefficient. They're wasting money and potentially be dangerous. So I would address this with a service contractor when he comes out to do your service, which you're going to call for tomorrow, okay? You want to make sure you get that done because it's important every winter to have a heating system serviced.
Okay, thank you.
All right, good luck with that project. Thanks so much for calling us at 888-MONEY-PIT.
Now we've got Trent in Florida on the line who's dealing with a fallen apart popcorn ceiling. How can we help you?
Well, my popcorn ceiling is actually in my bathroom. It's, I guess, one night or something, my son had gotten it wet. And when it dried, it started flaking off the ceiling. And now it's just continuing to do it.
Well, it's funny because when you get a popcorn ceiling wet, that's actually the way to remove it. You would spray it with, you know, some sort of garden sprayer and then scrape it off. So if you want it gone, he's got you on the correct
Now's
path.
The time, right? But if you don't want it gone, what I would do is this. I would take like a stiff bristle brush and gently brush away, maybe like a dry paintbrush, you know, and just brush away all the loose stuff. And then you're going to pick up some popcorn ceiling patching material. There's a number of different manufacturers of this. I know that Zinsser makes one. Homax makes one. It comes both on a trowel-on finish and also on a spray-on finish.
It looks like cheese in a can.
Yeah, exactly.
It looks
like Cheese Whiz. And yes. You can spray that on and recreate the popcorn effect that way. And then lastly, you're probably going to have to paint that ceiling and paint the entire ceiling to blend it in. But you got to get rid of the loose stuff, add the patching material, then repaint the ceiling, and you'll be good to go.
Okay. Well, great. Well, thank you very much.
Now you've got options. You're very welcome.
Jane Ellen in Pennsylvania is looking at getting some new windows. How can we help you make that decision?
Yes. Well, we're looking at getting replacing our single pane windows. And our question is, do you think it would be more cost effective to spend the extra money on triple pane windows, or would double pane windows be okay? Other than the windows, the house is fairly well insulated. It's not real drafty. We haven't priced our options yet, so we're looking for an opinion.
I think that double pane windows will be fine. The thing is that when you shop for windows, you have all of these different features and benefits that you have to compare and contrast, and sometimes it gets very confusing when you do that. What I would look for is a window that's Energy Star rated, and one that has double pane glass. As long as the glass is insulated and has like a low E coating so it reflects the heat back, that'll be fine. It's been my experience.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.